Hi guys, welcome back to Sleeve Saturday. So this week I got to sit down and interview the rock icon, Jim Peterik. Jim, of course, is the founder of the Ides of March, and of course, formerly of Survivor. You know me, I try to ask the questions that the fans want to hear. All this week, I'll be releasing several clips of our interview, you know, as a little teaser. The full interview will be released next weekend. Enjoy.
Very briefly, the one song you didn't write for Survivor, and, you know, I said I was born in 81. As a child, I remember Karate Kid, The Moment of Truth. Again, I don't ask you all the obvious questions. I'm trying to steer clear of them. But was it Bill Conti or John Avildsen, who himself had a Rocky connection, that contacted you for Moment of Truth, or how did that come about?
Yeah, it was, I think, my publisher sent it. And, you know, I listened to the demo, and yeah. And, I didn't even play it for Frankie, and Frankie goes, "What was that?" I said, "You know, Bill Conti wrote a song for the Karate Kid, wants us to do. Let me hear it." So, God bless Frankie, because I don't know if I would have put it in a drawer or, you know, what I would have thought. But when I played it for Frankie, he says, "Well, I think we can do something with this." And actually, that was the very first song. A lot of people don't know this. That Jimmy ever sang with us in the studio.
Right.
And of course, it was produced by Ron Nevis in that track, so it sounded great. But when I heard Jimmy sing it, he made a good song great. And that's what a great singer can do.
Absolutely. I wore out the VHS, and I mean the end of the credits, so I could hear that song. You know, I just kept rewinding that as a kid.
I know. I was so disappointed that most of the theater was gone before that song. Yeah. I hated that. I was so mad.
I know. I get you. But look, it found its audience. I'm 40 now, and here I am talking to Jim Peterik. You're just incredible. Incredible. Everyone knows that you contributed a song to Rocky IV, Burning Heart, around this time. Yeah. But the track that was omitted from that was Man Against the World. I saw you cover it recently in recent shows in the last 10 years. One of the best songs you've ever written. Again, another one just sets me off. When combined with Frankie's guitar and Jimmy's vocals, it's off the scale. Why did Stallone not include it in Rocky IV? Why not?
You know, he tried. But he was just one member of a production team that couldn't find a place for that song. And he tried again, not too many years ago, to put it on the end of the Rocky IV re-edition, you know.
Rocky versus Drago.
And no, this is the original movie.
All right, okay, got it.
Yeah, they restored it, they added scenes. He wanted to use it at the end. But again, he said, "Oh, sorry, Jim, you know, again, we had to use Burning Heart, you know." Okay, you know, but that song, it's like never had its day, really. You know, it's one of my best power ballads ever. You know, I mean, Frankie and me, but wow.
And a beautiful music video as well, and Jimmy in prime form, just unbelievable.
Yeah, I remember that. You know what? It was a good video.
Really good video.
Frankie running, and then the stop films, and great video.
Frankie was rocking the skinny jeans. I loved it.